God, you have already moved by your spirit, God. God, keep on moving, God, in the name of Jesus, God. Let them have it. Just a listen to hear this. That they may hear what the Spirit of the Lord is saying to the church, God. Bless us one by one, God. Then bless us all together, God. In Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. 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 First, give all praise and honor to my Lord and Savior, sweet Jesus Christ. Amen. To Apostle Edwards and to all of God's people. It's good to be in the house of the Lord one more time. If I heard that word, I could just go on home. Amen. 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 God really used those two mighty women of God.
Yes.
Glory to God. Amen.
We are
talking about don't let them talk you out of it. Amen. And as I got a revelation on this week. And I know that's our subject, but I'm going to give you an introduction. Amen? Is that okay?
Amen.
And I was in the room with the client, and the lady said, she was talking, she said, you got kids? I said, yes, I have 5 kids. I said, how many you have? She said, me got 1. I said, okay, well, praise God. And she said, you got husband? I said, no, husband passed. She said, well, I said, you got husband. She said, no, nobody looks at me. I said, why not? She said, he went left me for a pretty woman, small woman. I said, oh, I'm sorry. I said, God gonna bless you with one. And then it came to my mind, I said, she is in a situation. There's a situation that we all have in our life. Amen?
Amen.
We have a situation, and I'm sitting by the road and blind. Our subject is, don't let them talk you out of it.
All right.
Sitting by the road is one thing,
yes.
And blind is another thing.
Yes.
All
right.
You know, when you are sitting by the road and you're blind, you got a situation.
Amen.
Yes.
But when they were blind, but they heard. Mm-hmm. See, sometimes we are not naturally blind, but we are physically blind.
Yes.
We talk about, oh, what the devil is doing. The devil doing this. But you ought to see what the Spirit of the Lord is doing.
Amen.
God is moving by his Spirit. He meets us up here every Sunday. I'm not going to be with you long. Matthew chapter 20, we have already read it. Verses 30. Everyone had it. We're going to read. And behold, 2 men sitting by the wayside, and when they heard that Jesus passed by, they cried out, saying, have mercy upon us, O Lord, thy son of David. See, sometimes you got to open your mouth to get God's attention.
Amen.
Yes, yes.
Sometimes we want to pity patty, you know, too ashamed to say, Lord, have mercy upon me.
Yes.
We said, Lord, have mercy upon me. God wanted you to open up your mouth. Like Sister said, when we was out there in the world, we opened up our mouth, didn't we not?
Yes.
Amen. If you want God, if you want something from God, you have to open up your mouth.
Amen. That's true.
We are sitting in church, not mentally blind, but some of us are spiritually blind.
Yes.
We are not sitting by the road, but we are sitting in church. 2 men sitting by the road. They never said that they got dropped off.
Come on.
Somebody may have dropped them off. Because sometimes when you are blind and people have to lead you, sometimes people get tired of you. Whatever situation you have, people sometimes get tired of you. But sometimes, you know I'm right, you want to hang on somebody's shoulder all day long, all night long. They never said how they got there. They may have been dropped off. And they may have been staying with someone, or maybe they got tired of leaving them around day by day, night by night. You know, people, being honest, we get tired of each other. But God, he won't get tired of you. He'll never get tired of you. He said, cast all your cares on him because he cared for you. So no matter what the situation look like, no matter what problem you have, just call on Jesus. They said, call on him, he'll answer prayer. Open up your mouth and tell God what you want. There's a song that says, Jesus on the main line, tell him what you want.
Yes.
He said he'll always know what you want, but he want him to, but he wants you to talk to him. He wants you to open up your mouth and tell him. Someone may be sitting beside you and they tell you, be quiet. It don't take all that. But you need to look at that person and say, I can't keep my mouth closed. Because you don't know what that person have been in. You don't know what the situation that person is going on in their life on today. You need to tell God if you need a healing. You need to tell God you need a healing in your body.
Yes.
Because God, he's the God to supply all of our needs. If you need deliverance, you need to tell God you need deliverance.
Right.
You know, sometimes we don't have peace of mind. We all go to and fro, home and back to work. This is far. I walk 10 minutes to work every day because where they got the place that we can't park in front, and I have to walk 10 minutes to work. I said, Lord, just give me strength in my body.
Yes.
Give me a peace of mind that I can work the way you want me to work.
Yes.
But God said, whatever you need, he's got it. Whatever problem, situation you have, you need to open up your mouth and tell God about it.
Yes.
We tell everybody, then Tom, Harry, Sue, and Mo. But we need to call on Jesus.
Yes.
Because Jesus, he can work it out.
He can work
yes,
out.
He can.
He said, I called on the Lord.
Yes.
And he worked it out.
Amen.
We need peace of mind. We need financial blessing. Some of us need God to do something special in our life. But we keep quiet. We will not open up our mouth. We are afraid of what someone will say. You know, I used to have a quiet, well, my spirit is sometimes quiet. But when I first got called, I was a little shy. My page was shaking like a leaf on a tree. God said, Tommie, I don't give you a spirit of fear, but I give you a spirit of power, love, and a sound mind.
Yes.
Some people say, you don't have to shout. But the devil is alive. God, spirit of move, you just shout on anyway.
Yes.
It reminds me of that lady, amen, that had an issue of blood. I know people was talking about her. She needs to sit her nasty self down. She needs to just be quiet and just sit down. But that lady said, if I can just touch the hem of his garment, I know I will be made whole.
Yes.
See, people want to just put all the weight on. We talked about weight on this morning. We talked about all this weight. But we need to keep our mind focused on Jesus. He said, if you keep your mind stayed up on him, he will keep you in perfect peace. Amen?
Amen.
We don't have peace on today. We have all this kind of things is going on in our lives. But if we need to open up our mouth. Back to the men that were blind. They were blind, sitting by the road and blind. But they heard, they couldn't see, but they heard that Jesus was passing by.
Yes, Lord.
They said, son, I'm just putting it on my own term. Lord, have mercy on me.
Yes.
I got a situation and I need you to heal my eyes so that I can see. But they said, shh. Be quiet. Sit down. You don't have to be doing all of that. But if you're blind, but they cried out even the louder. Lord, I'm proof. Son of mercy, have mercy on me. And when you speak loud, open up your mouth and say, what do you want? But they said, Lord, that I may see. Because if they said, Lord, I need to see. God didn't hear you. God didn't hear you. Open up your mouth. You open up your mouth when you went to, I tell the devil, Terry told you, open up your mouth. Like your sister said, she was on the dance floor. We need to get God's attention. Open up your mind and let go and let God have his way. She said she was not going to let Jesus pass by. Two blind men didn't see, but they heard. Some of us, we got ears, but we can't hear. God's word said, the day you hear my voice, harden not your heart. So we need to open up our spiritual ears, our spiritual eyes, and see how God is moving by his spirit. Some people say the devil is busy, but I stop by to tell you, sisters and brothers, that God is moving by his spirit. He meets us here every Sunday. He's moving by his Holy Ghost power. So whatever you need, don't let them talk you out of it. Glory to God. Tell the devil and all his helpers, the witchcraft workers and all his helpers, that you are unstoppable. Glory to God. I don't care what nobody says. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continue to be in my mouth. No matter what's going on, they will say, oh, God can't use you. God can't use you. You need to sit down. God can't use you. You need to sit down. But I'm gonna tell you this. If Jacob was here, he said God used him because he had a problem, because he was a cheater. If Peter was here, he said God used him because he had a temper. If David was here, David said he had a friend with another man's wife, so God used him. Amen. If Noah was here, Noah said, I got drunk. If Jonah was here, Jonah said, I ran from God. If Paul was here, Paul said, I was a murderer. If Gilman was here, Gilman said, I was insecure. If Mira was here, Mira said, I was a gossip. If Martha was here, Martha said, I was a warrior. If Thomas was here, Thomas said, I was a doubter. If Sarah was here, Sarah said, I was impatient. If Elijah was here, Elijah said, I was moody. If Moses was here, Moses said, I stuttered. If Zachariah was here, Zachariah said, I was short. If Abraham was in Abraham, I was old. If Zion was a lot of that, you know. God used me. He raised me from the dead. And now, right now, I'm here. Thomas said, God used me because she had an anger problem. So if God can use you, God can use you. Glory to God. Hallelujah.